So, over there you crush it all. It comes up. Okay, so this is where all the crushed up stuff goes in?
Yep, and it mixes with water.
Okay.
You spin those around real fast.
How fast? Oh, so cool.
John was probably thinking. Usually we're about here.
50 meters.
I don't know what that translates into the RPM. So about like that.
Okay.
We let it, depending on the beer, we use a different temperature of water, and we mash it at a different temperature, and that basically you can control how sweet the beer is at the end.
So how come there's only blazing on the bottom half? Do you not ever fill higher than that, or just like
no,
it sits down?
We fill to, I mean, you can kind of see where the line is.
Okay,
yesterday.
Yeah.
But we've been running it, we used to run it this direction.
Uh-huh.
And I felt that if we ran it the opposite direction, it would push the grain down, and it would have nowhere to go, and we'd best get better convection, or whatever, and we'd get better mixing.
Yeah,
so
okay.
We did that yesterday, and it seemed to work pretty well, where you can see the stuff coming up on the side and pushing down in the center. So it mixes pretty well.
Okay.
And we've run it for like an hour. So it's all pretty well mixed up by then.
So are you same as next door, or are you guys different?
Yep.
Okay.
Yeah, this is the production facility, and the brewery over there primarily serves in-house.
Okay.
So they supply.
That's all that making
they
stuff over there.
He's brewing today. So he makes the stuff that they serve across the street.
Okay.
We bottle, we peg out, we go all over the place.
Okay, that's cool.
So after it's sitting here.
Yeah.
So then the next one, this one.
Okay.
And those stir around and a lot slower.
Okay.
And this is where we basically start to collect the wort. It's like the sugar water, basically, that you get. So we'll collect it in here, add a little bit more water, and then we start transferring it to that vessel over there.
Uh-huh.
And as it's transferring, you add more water on the top.
Okay.
So the sugar kind of trickles through like you're making a cup of coffee, essentially.
Okay.
Rinsing the water through the grain to get the sugar out.
Oh, okay, gotcha.
So then, it goes into here, and this is where we boil it. So we'll collect it usually to the about this stair, or a little lower. One of those two stairs, depending on batch size and strength. And then we boil it for an hour and a half. And this is the part, where we start adding hops. I don't know if you know much about brewing, but
I know.
Like the earlier you throw the hops in, the more bittering it comes out.
The hops, is that like the grain or?
No, the hops is a flour that we use.
Okay,
gotcha. Yeah.
So the earlier you throw it in, the bitter it is?
The more bitter, yeah. And then.
Yeah, I was going to say bitterer, but that doesn't really work.
That boils, or that drives off a lot of the volatile oils that would give you the aromatic. So, boiling a long time, you don't get a lot of the flavor or the aroma because it just blasts it out the chimney. So then we'll add more hops later to get more of the flavor. And then even in there, which is the whirlpool, which is where it swirls around and we let all the solids collect out so that we can transfer clear beer.
So that's where all the excess grain that's still left comes out.
No, the grain all stays in there.
Oh, it does.
So
okay.
By the time, yeah, so the grain stays in there, and it's pretty clean when it comes through here. But the boiling coagulates some of the proteins and the carbohydrates and makes gunk.
Okay.
And so we try to leave the gunk behind either in this or in here.
Okay, interesting.
And we even add more hops to this, which gives you more of an aroma and a flavor, and then we add, even more hops once the beer is done fermenting and more of the extract.
that's where they sit and ferment.
Yep.
So some breweries would put it in like a barrel, right? But like you guys would leave it in there? Or?
Well, we do barrel aging, but if we finish it in the steel first, and then we age it in the barrel.
Okay.
Actually, we do have something that's fermenting pretty hard right now.
Okay.
The beer we just made yesterday looks like it's going off. You can see it.
Yeah, I saw that.
Bucket full of foam. We just made that yesterday, so it's fermenting really hard right now.
Dang, okay.
We can go down there and smell it.
I think I smelled it when I was out. When I walked around outside that way, I smelled something. It smelled so good. I have to say.
What you're smelling right now is what we're bottling. I can smell that.
Yeah, really fruity. Yeah.
It smells like peachy almost.
Yeah, I guess I was gonna say something like fruity. So is
that? That'll go away. That flavor will go away.
That's so unfortunate. Wait, so like, what flavor is that? Like,
it's
do beers have flavor?
The yeast is doing it.
Oh, okay. Does it always smell the same, or like?
This yeast does. We use a couple different types of yeast, and they don't all do that. This one does, and it's given me some ideas for making peach beer. Just because it's really nice. And then after it goes into the tanks with the foam on the bottom, we dump all the, there's usually a bunch of solids, so we'll dump all the solids out the bottom and then transfer the beer into one of these.
Check this out, fermenting. This is so cool. I just share on Snapchat.
Oh yeah. So then it'll go into a tank like this. And we have three. There's two back over there.
Okay.
And this is where the beer gets carbonated.
Okay.
So we put it in really cold. Usually we ferment around 70 degrees, depending on the beer. For a lager, it's like 50.
What's the difference with a lager and ale?
Just the yeast.
Okay.
Lager yeasts are usually colder fermented. They don't produce a lot of fruity flavors. They're known for producing a little bit of sulfur, like a pleasant amount, not like brimstone.
Yeah.
Not like you just lit a match.
Okay.
Although it does smell like that, when it's not like peaches, it'll smell like a dragon.
And so that's where, so it's not carbonated yet. It goes into the tube though and becomes carbonated.
Well, no, there's a ceramic stone in here, and we pump CO2 through the stone, so it creates tons, like billions and billions of bubbles coming out. It's the surface
through
area.
Stone?
Through a ceramic, yeah. I can show you, I think we have one.
Okay.
And the CO2 dissolves into the solution. It usually takes a day or two.
Oh, into that.
What's that?
It goes into that, and that's what it does.
The air comes out.
Oh, through the hole. Yeah, okay.
Yeah, they're pretty wild.
Are like micro holes in that thing? That like,
yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Dang, that is crazy.
That was, that's a chemical. Can't ever trust chemicals.
Alright, so all the grain goes up into there, guys. Then it goes into this machine here. And then from that, it gets grinded up. And it goes... It goes up here into these, where it gets mixed even more. And then it... then what happens?
Add water. So we steep it, basically like making a cup of tea with a very specific...
Then they add water, which is kind of like, you know, when you make a cup of tea, and then they try to pull out all the, they leave all the grain excess behind, and then it goes over here to ferment. It goes over here to ferment, where it does those awesome bubbles. And then you guys carbonate it right here, and then you bottle it.
Yep, or we put it in a keg.
Okay.
Which is what I was doing.
Okay, oh yeah, show it, yeah.
We just hook that up in the keg and...
Yeah, nice. So, is it possible to see the other side of the bottling?
The other side?
Yeah.
Yeah, we can walk back this way.
Because also, I'm a supply chain major at school, so this is really interesting to me.
Yeah. Cool.
When he said you could see the bottling, I was like, that's cool. Okay, that is awesome.
This
so it's
is
all
really
cool right now.
This is between that and this are probably the two most interesting parts of the process.
So, the lid was put on but not tightened yet? Is that what's happening?
No, I think that's just stabilizing it. So the machine knows exactly where it is or that it has a bottle.
Oh, okay. Oh, there's a label there. Okay, I see it. Yeah, I heard him screaming. I was wondering if something was going on earlier. Goes out.